So I guess we'll introduce you to everybody. Just before we get into why BMW and why we're looking at your, well, at least for you, it's only a week old, right?
Week old.
E92 M3. Just give us a little bit of background about yourself.
Sure. My name is Vinny Budrum, lifelong car enthusiast. You know, something that I've been born with, I think, since I was 4 years old, always into cars, just everything about it.
Okay.
Started as an enthusiast, turned it into a business, and now, you know, we're building wheels and doing customizing for Elite Design Concepts. I've been an M3 guy since 2009.
Okay.
I started actually with the E92 M3, same color combo. This actually takes me back to when I first picked my car up. This is how it looked when I walked in the dealership. So,
okay.
Yeah. So since 2009, I've been an M3 guy.
You have had and you have cars other than BMWs.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
You told me something special about this plate.
2009, I got my first M3.
Mm-hmm.
2011, I started Elite Design Concepts.
Okay.
And it was EDC01, that was the plate for the car. And in 2012, I got rid of my E92 and got into a 997 Turbo. And you know, when I got into that car, it was like, nice car, you know, I always wanted the Porsche, but I had a hard time letting this car go. Everyone used to be like, oh, why are you driving all these other cars with the BMW Car Club plate? I'm like, there's a reason for it, you know, so.
How many different models of M3s have you had over the years?
So I've had a E36. That was Estoril Blue with the Dove interior.
Okay.
I had the E46, which was the Tiag. It has the titanium silver with the black interior.
Okay.
I had the F80, which was last year's model. And I obviously the car I first started with was the 92 M3.
What is it about the older M models?
It's a driving feel. They all have their different characteristics. Mm. Their motors are different, you know. It's like an E46 car. Probably one of the friendlier cars of the M3 class to drive. Really easy to drive, fun. The motor is potent in every gear.
Mm-hmm.
The E36 was like, you know, just a fun car. You take it back to 99 and it's like, wow.
Yeah.
A lot of car for 99. This car in particular always got me because it's such a different animal. You got to really learn the car. You got to understand it. The V8, I mean, I remember when they brought this car out, there was so much, you know, a lot of talk about the fact that, oh, it's a V8. Listen, you need to sit in this car, start it up, listen to the motor, you know, just feel it out. Hold the fat steering wheel, and, you know, if you know how to drive this thing, it's a lot of fun. So I feel like this car, I really connected with it.
Mm-hmm.
It was something that I bonded with, and I love everything about it. It's been a week of just pure joy.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
It's two different types of cars. You can short shift it all day in the city, but then you get it on the highway and you put your foot into it and you let it wind out and it's a totally different animal. Totally different animal.
Hold on, and the V8, I mean, the way the noises it makes, the sounds it makes, the way the car delivers the power, I mean, you know, if you move around with this car, it goes with you.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just a capable car. And, you know, the way I consider it, it's an experienced car. It's maybe not the fastest car out there, but the driving feel behind it is incredible. The M3 is the benchmark car.
Mm-hmm.
And that's one of the things that always appealed to me about this car, because everyone's always built to compete with it.
That's true.
Whoever's been faster on paper or whatever measurements you want to, the reality is all the competition built around the M3.
Yeah.
And the history of the M3, from the E30 being, you know, a requirement to be a race car,
yeah,
building 5,000 of them. I mean, it's a history that I think you want to be a part of.
It
stands for something. It means something. You know, M is amazing.
And I definitely want to have you back.
Absolutely.
Once you do whatever it is you're going to do to this.
Oh, yeah.
But beyond obviously putting a set of EDC wheels on it, is there anything else that you're looking to do?
Oh,
is
yeah.
just going to be your basic stuff?
This is a passion build for me.
Mm-hmm.
This car, you know, it got me started. It's almost like me paying homage to my first build, because like you said, which I'm thankful for, you know, we've had a good couple of years of success. We try to do the right thing with integrity and quality all the way through for everybody we work with. And this was my platform to start with.
Yeah.
So this is my baby to come back to and just build it the way I want to build it. And it's going to be really nice. I'm touching every part of the car.
Mm-hmm.
You know, from wheels to interior to, I mean, everything. So this should be ready, I would say, for next season. Right now, I'm bonding with them. I'm seeing an old friend that's been gone for a while. So right now, I'm just enjoying that aspect of the car.
Awesome. Well, I mean, this has been a blast, and best of continued luck with EDC and the plans you have for this. And May 2018, we'll see it here.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm excited. I'm happy to be here. I'm thankful for the interview. You know, I've taken many a delivery here before. So
there we go.
You know, yeah.
Always want to keep it in the family.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Thanks again, man.
All right.